Good evening, everyone. Welcome to Trinity, and you're in for a treat. Wisconsin Lutheran Seminary Chorus is here tonight, and I heard them warming up, and wow. That's what you will say at the end of this concert, probably after the first piece even. So excited to have the chorus here on first trip, first stop on their tour. And if you happen to be one of the hosts putting up some of the students tonight, just so you know, after the concert, they have to take their robes off, they have to put stuff away, come back into the sanctuary, and we'll pair you up with the students you have. But after the concert, go on out. They have a table out there for CDs. Please buy some CDs. There's an offering plate in the back as well to help them on all the expenses that they have on this trip. Enough of me talking. Let's bring in the chorus.
Thank you. I'm sorry. I will be true.
I will wait for you till my soul. Please stand for the reading of the gospel. The gospel according to St. Matthew, chapter 9. Jesus went through all the towns and villages, teaching in their synagogues, proclaiming the good news of the kingdom, and healing every disease and sickness. When he saw the crowds, he had compassion on them, because they were harassed and helpless, like sheep without a shepherd. Then he said to his disciples, "The harvest is plentiful, but the workers are few. Ask the Lord of the harvest, therefore, to send out workers into his harvest field." The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. When Jesus looked out at that crowd of people, what did he see? Did he see a group of people who had their lives put together, who had life figured out? No, not really. He looked out at that crowd and he saw them as they truly were, sheep without a shepherd. He looked out at that crowd of people and he saw them as people whose eternal lives were in jeopardy, with their thoughts fixed on their physical problems and their physical needs, with not a thought going to the real problem at the center of them all, their own spiritual depravity as sinners, burdened by the weight of their own imperfection and guilt. And it was every single one of them. A world wandering about in the darkness with nothing to guide them. Sheep without a shepherd. When we think about the world that we live in today, can we say that much has changed? Can we say that people are any less concerned about their physical problems? Can we say that people have a generally strong grasp on the problem of sin and the punishment it poses? Or would we say that most people have some kind of guiding light in their life, something that gives them a sense of purpose or direction, but in the end it's inevitably unsatisfied, unfulfilled endeavors that are less of a guiding light and really just more darkness in disguise? If that's true, when we look out at the world and we see all those people, do we see them as just people who are living life for the wrong reasons? Or do we see them as they truly are? Sheep without a shepherd. And then what happens when we look in the mirror? You and I both know that sometimes we can start to wander off and get lost. And yeah, maybe it happens more often than we'd like to admit. It happens when life's distractions start to take first priority. It happens when we start to look for solutions to life's problems in places other than God's Word. That's when we start to wander off and get lost. And yeah, maybe it happens more often than we'd like to admit. But here's the thing. Our good shepherd comes and finds us every time. Because just as he looked at the people back then, so he looks at you and me today and every day. He looks at us and he loves us. He loves us enough to have taken our place, to be the sacrificial lamb on the altar of the cross. He loves us enough to take on the weight of every single one of our shameful acts and disgusting deeds, every single one of our failures and shortcomings. He took on all of them. And he loves us enough to have died the death we deserve and suffer the hell we've earned. Why? Because when he looks at you and me, he loves us. Brothers and sisters, when he looks at the rest of the world, looks at them in the exact same way. And the humbling part is, we're the ones whom God has chosen to share the light of that wonderful good news message. God has commissioned His church to go out and tell the people of the world that Jesus died for them so that they could live with Him. That's just it, isn't it, though? The people of the world. It's a lot of people to talk to. It's a big job. The harvest is plentiful. So what do? Ask the Lord of the harvest to send out workers. Pray for pastors. Pray that more people would consider the public ministry. Encourage the young men in your life to consider whether they have the gifts and the desire to be under-shepherds for the Good Shepherd. At Wisconsin Lutheran Seminary, written above the doors to the chapel, is a daily reminder for each of the men who are just standing in front of you. Keruxeta ta oiongelion. It's Greek for preach the gospel. Tell about Jesus and His love. Proclaim Him as the light in this sin-stained world. Be workers in the harvest field of God. We train for that, and we do that, so that when we look out at the world, we don't just see a bunch of people living life for the wrong reasons. No, we do that so that when we look at them, we can see them as they truly are. Sheep without a shepherd. So that when we look at them, we can love them as He first loved us. Brothers and sisters, as Christians, as fellow members of God's flock, you can too. So, let's get to work. God grant it. Amen. For our next song, I invite the congregation to sing along with verses 1, 2, 4, and 5. It's a little different from what's in the program. 1, 2, 4, and 5.
Please stand for the hymn.
Thank you.
Jesus Christ, let's rest.
Shall my spirit Do you feel the world is broken?
We do.
Do you feel the shadows deepen?
We do.
But do you know that all the dark won't stop the light from getting through?
We do.
Do you wish that you could see it all made new? Is all creation groaning?
It is.
Is a new creation coming?
It is.
Is the glory of the Lord to be the light within our midst?
It is.
Is it good that we remind ourselves of? Is he worthy? Is he worthy?